High School Musical.
During scene changes, as there will be actors singing and dancing in the aisles.
We
We also have people we want to thank before we start the show, starting off with Mrs. Sargers, Mrs. Thomas, Mr. Crozier, Ms. Gina, and Ms. Greco for all their help in our production, as well as Mrs. Umstead, Mr. Huber, Mr. Toner, Mr. Pham. We could not do this without you, all the stepdads, all the costumes, who helped us out so much, and we just want to thank you so much.
There will also be fog effects used in the show, but they are just water vapor, so don't worry, as they will not trigger anyone's allergic reactions.
And finally, I'm Annie.
And I'm Megan.
And you're watching Disney's High School Musical on Stage.
Thank you. no, really, I can't say.
Get out of there.
Well, you know what? Someday, you guys just might thank me for this. Or not. I'm Troy. I can't say.
Gabriella, me either.
They're all looking at us.
Sure.
Actually, I did meet a boy.
So make with the newsflash, sister. I'm all ears.
It was the best trip. The slopes were perfect, and I met the hottest girl ever.
You'll never guess how I met him.
How'd you meet him?
Snowboarding?
Snowboarding.
Singing. He was pretty good, too.
It was awesome.
It's like a dream.
I made a New Year's resolution to call and ask her out on a date.
You know what my New Year's resolution is?
Tell it!
Please save your mind.
intuitive aesthetic. As usual, the drama club faces a dearth of male participants, so please come out and audition. I am offering you the chance to spread your wings into bold new horizons. I am offering you the timeless allure of the greased paint. The magical power of the clean light. All right. I'm offering you extra credit. The dreaded cell phone symphony returns to our crucible of learning. Sharpay and Ryan Evans, your phones. We have Ryan. We have a zero tolerance policy for cell phones in this classroom, which is why we'll be getting to know each other very well in detention. And welcome to East High, Ms. Montez. Troy Bolton, I see your phone is involved as well.
That's not even a possibility. Ms. Starvis, your honor, sir, needs to be at basketball practice, and Troy is...
Mr. Danforth! 30 minutes. Count them.
That might be difficult for Chad, since he probably can't count that high.
Taylor McKessie! 35 minutes.
But I've never had a detention in my life.
Well then, happy New Year's! This ain't my first time at the rodeo, kiddies! Shall the carnage continue? Ah, saved by the bell. I'll see you in detention.
Thank you. late. When the going gets tough,
it's tough gets going!
Guess you guys know that one. Alright, give me 10 minutes of weave drills. And show a little hustle.
Thank you.
should be 10 to the negative 18th power. That's all.
10 to the negative 18th power? That's quite impossible. Are you impressed with Welcome Aboard?
Did you know that you spent a year in juvenile hall? Something to do with cats and lawnmowers.
Be gone, witch. You have no powers here.
Whatever.
Huh? I'm impressed. You're a genius.
Please, it's just an equation. Brian, it's me. I thought Miss Garvis took your phone away.
What? We always carry a spare in case our agent calls.
Anyway, our science decathlon has this week, which will match coming up on Friday, and we've never won it before, but if you're on our side, we might stand a chance.
Thanks, but I think we'll pass for now. I just want to get acclimated to the new school now.
Promise you'll think about it.
Promise. Brian, what's the update?
Troy Bolton was looking at our audition list.
Again? Ugh, he was hanging around with that Montez hag this morning, and they were both looking at the list. Well, there's something freaky about her. Did you Google her like I asked?
Yeah, it's like she has an extra brain or something. So why is she interested in our music?
She's interested in Troy, barf boy. I need you to plant those printouts and tail us off her ASAP, okay?
No problemo, boss. But why am I doing that?
Look, there's no harm in making certain that Gabriella is welcome to track activities that are appropriate for her. You know, the ones that keep her far away from Troy Bolton!
Well, Wildcats, it's time to kiss today goodbye and point me towards detention. So all you evildoers, better get her butt to the theater immediately, or face the wrath of Darkness the Merciless. This is Jack Scott signing off.
Yes, my brave little detention menagerie. We thespians often use animals to build upon the characters we play. Be the bear, be the ostrich, be the monkey. You're all doing wonderfully. Chum, 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 now explore. Wait. Brian, do you want to be an ostrich?
Totally.
Brian. Yes? Unless you want to live the rest of your life in the shadows of your sister's ostrich.
Of course, we'd love to have our own team. With credentials like these, we'll get that title for sure.
Where did those come from?
They didn't shoot them in my locker.
Of course not.
Well, we'd still love to have you. We meet almost every day after school. Please?
I don't know. I think I need to catch up on curriculum here before I think about joining the colors.
But what a perfect way to get caught up! Meeting with the smartest kids in school? Wow, what a generous offer, Taylor!
Before. It could be our Auntie Claire.
Okay, I guess I'll do it.
Thank you.
Okay, so quick pro quo. What do you know about Troy Bolton?
I wouldn't consider myself an expert on the not popular subspecies. Unless you speak cheerleader. As in, oh my god, isn't Troy Bolton just a hottie supermodel?
I guess I don't speak cheerleader.
Which is why we live in an alternate universe to Troy, the basketball boy.
Have you ever tried to get to know him?
He has his account. I have mine. You'll see how it works when you sit with us at lunch.
I mean, you don't think being in a musical could be fun? I'm a little. You're a hoops student, not some musical singer person. Oh, no, I wasn't talking about me. Good. Because you can't expect the rest of us to be focusing on winning the championship. Get off somewhere. Singing in leotards or something.
Oh, no one said anything about leotards.
Not yet, my friend. Just wait.
You're all doing lovely. James. Now everyone gather in a circle for our last little exposure to the theater. James! Our last activity is called the Ball of Noise. I know. The objective is to pass around an invisible ball while making some kind of noise to go with it. Once the ball reaches you, it can land on any part of the body. You are limited only by your own imagination. I'll start.
Joie de vie.
Next, work hard till
deeply disturbing. Please see a therapist.
Side me, but I'm so low, no, it's your boy. Troy.
song that Brian and Trapeze sang, right?
Uh-huh.
And the entire show?
Uh-huh.
That's awesome. How long did it take you to write it?
You know, it's just about 2 years. And I get up at 5 every day before school, but I'm still working on the finale.
You're so dedicated. So, why don't you just let Sharpay boss you around? I mean, it's your show.
It is?
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I mean, isn't the author of a play kind of like the playmaker in basketball?
Playmaker?
Yeah, you know, the person that makes everyone else look good. Playmaker does.
I know. Do you want to hear the way that song's supposed to sound?
That's really beautiful.
What's up?
What's going on?
Thank you.
singing and dancing on tables in the school cafeteria. Clicks have gone wild in an unprecedented response to Troy Bolton's callback for the school musical. One skater dude. Was even seen mixing in with the school band string section. Oh, the humanity! The humanity!
Best friend. way, so now that Troy's going to be in your show...
Troy Bolton is not in my show.
Oh. Well, did you like the cake I made for you?
No, it doesn't go with my pants.
Oh. That's funny, I guess. So, anyway, I was thinking, maybe you'd like to continue playing basketball.
I'd rather suck the mucus from a dog's nostrils till its skull caves in!
That doesn't sound very appetizing. Wouldn't you prefer a nice crimper leg? Tarte de foe? Tiramisu? I wouldn't say tiramisu.
I'm not playing.
Some very reliable She's going to have to prove it to me. But I will not allow either of you to make a joke out of my drama club.
You'll need my help to do that.
That's you! Mr. I'm sorry, I'm flying!
I'm Miss Darvis.
I thought you were genuine, Troy! Wrong again, I guess!
What was that all about?
Do you want to tell me something? Something about singing?
What? No. I mean, you know.
No, I don't know. You think Mrs. Darvis? The deranged? I don't even know what that is. She just chewed my head off because she thinks you're plotting something against her.
It was nothing. I was just helping someone audition.
You have the biggest goal of your life coming up in 2 days. Did you win the game for you?
I was gonna stay and work my free throws.
Since you're late, again, that's the least you can do.
Detention was my fault, not hers.
You haven't missed practice in 3 years, and that girl shows up in your late twice?
That girl is named Gabriella, and she's very nice.
Making you miss practice doesn't make her very nice in my book or your team's.
She's not a problem. She's just a girl.
But you're not just a guy. Without, you're the team captain. Without you completely focused, we won't win that championship game. And championship games don't come along very often. There's something special.
A lot of things are special.
If you blow this chance, you will regret it for the rest of your life.
You mean like you?
You're a playmaker, Bolton, not a singer.
Did you ever think that maybe I could be both? And it's Troy, Dad. Not Bolton.
Champions you came before. You're the hero that you love.
bonehead basketball marauder shop. And you, you're the future civilization.
I can't believe that
classic. And besides, why do I always have to do what you tell me?
Maybe because I know what I'm doing. Just do what I tell you to do. I'm not taking any chances, understand? That role is mine. I was born to play it.
Okay, somebody in this room ought to chill out, sister, and
Well, it ain't me.
What are you worried about anyways? We always get the roles wrong.
I'm not just talking about my role in the play, Ryan. I'm talking about my role in, like, the school. I'm not a jock, I'm not a brainiac. But you know what I am? I'm the star! That's my role! And if you take it away from me, who am I?
I mean, you could just be Sharpay. That's not so bad, is it?
Are you brain dead? No one's going to like me if I'm just Sharpay. But on stage, I can be Juliet. I can be Annie Oakley. I can be anyone I want to be. Not just some dumb old Sharpay. I need something to make me fabulous, Ryan. I mean, come on, they named me after a flabby dog.
Sharpay, we've gotten the leads every year since birth, and if we get them again, then great, but if not, we'll still be fabulous. And you know, it could have been worse. I could have named you Shih Tzu Maltese.
But Troy and that thing.
Maybe Troy would like you more if you just yourself was.
Oh, pardon me, Dr. Phil, but what do you know? You're just a kid.
I'm only 8 minutes younger than you.
Yeah, well, those are 8 very important minutes.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know you guys were in here.
Hi, Troy. Did you come to ask if I'd switch partners and audition with you? The answer is yes, girl, you're fired.
Okay.
No. Have you guys seen Gabriella? I really gotta talk to her.
Who?
Forget it.
Truly. The last time I saw her, she was in the practice room about 10 minutes ago.
Well, thanks, Ryan. You know, you're all right.
How could you stab me in the back like that? Helping the enemy?
I stabbed you in the back?
Well, at least you admit it. Now, take it from the top and lose those jazz squares.
Hey, Pubble? Maybe that's because I don't want to be just the basketball guy anymore. Gabriella, I look in your eyes. I know that I can be anyone I want to be. So you look at me without putting all these limits on me.
Your dad.
This isn't about my dad. This is about me. And I'm not letting my team down. They're letting me down. No, I'm going to sing. How about you?
I don't want you.
It feels so right to be here with you. Oh, and now looking in your eyes, feeling my heart, the start of something new. Thank you.
something has changed. Never felt this way. I know it for real. This could be the start of something new. It feels so right to be here with you.
Through other eyes,
make a choice,
make a new connection,
make
class today. Go Drama Club!
Old Grandma? See, that's telling. Wait.
Taylor?
Yeah?
How do you spell drama?
Same here.
Go Drama Club!
Fasten your seatbelts, kiddies. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
First drama. If all the bets are all starting immediately. The science decathlon is in the second floor lab. The callbacks for Juliet and Romeo are in the theater, and the league basketball championship game is in the gym. Wildcats rule, baby. And the game is just about to begin as the red-hot Eastside Wildcats take the court, led by their team captain, Troy Bolton.
Ladies and gentlemen, let the callbacks begin.
We have exactly 2 minutes to solve the equation. Ready, set, and...
But
yeah,
It's not a joke. I want to give it my best shot.
Please, we only have a few more minutes until the lights come back on.
What's this? A full house?
As president of the drama club, I have to put my foot down. No preferential treatment. Those are your words, not mine.
Ms. Darbus, Troy wasn't trying to ruin your auditions. Sharpay lied because she thought she was going to get the part.
Shut up! Sharpay, is he telling the truth? Did you abuse the presidential privilege and knowingly lie to me? I didn't lie. I improvised a little. We'll talk about this later, Miss Evans. For now, off the stage. But Miss Darbus, the stage!
We'll sing without music.
Oh, no, you won't. Pianist here, Miss Darbus.
You really don't want to do that.
Oh, yes, I really do. Ready on stage. Now that's showbiz.
To the place to be.
too.
I wonder where he gets it from.
Sorry.
No, seriously. Where does he get it from?
We won too.
Too many game ball. So you're coming with me to the after party, right?
Like a date?
Must be your lucky day.
Or yours.
Tell her.
Gabriella! Congratulations!
And
I'm sorry I lied to Jarvis about you and Troy.
We'll spell that until, right?
Right. I guess I'm gonna have to play the unveil nurse. Unless you can't go on, that is. So, break a leg!
Huh? It means good luck in theater.
Thanks, Sharpay.
Don't mention it. To anyone. Ever.
I'm sorry to make the relationship.
We're in the club.
But I still think you're really great.
You do? Like, really, really?
Like, really, really.
So, where's that creme brulee you promised me?
Just a kindergarten, right?
Only better.
Yourself. Garnet proudly at our football game, our volleyball game, and at our show. Go Jags!